Hey folks, Ray from DCRainmaker.com here. Today we've got a look at the new FulGaz app on Apple TV. Now FulGaz is of course not the first app to come to Apple TV and not even the first trainer app, but they are the second app and number two matters. I'm talking apps of course. And what FulGaz is basically an app that takes outside video rides, so rides like up Duez and all sorts of famous and just kind of cool places, not even super famous, just like cool places to see, and allows you to re-ride them indoors. Of course there are a number of different apps that do this, but FulGaz has slowly kind of climbed the ranks of having a fairly well curated collection of these sort of rides, and they're doing some really cool technology stuff behind the scenes with how they use like the Climb and some of the other trainers to make that experience super, super clean. Now, of course, I want to talk about them because there isn't just only two trainer apps out there. It's not just Zwift and Trainer Road. There are literally almost two dozen different apps out there in the indoor training world. And I've talked about, for example, Vertigo up there early this winter, and Road Grand Tours up there this past spring. And so there's lots of neat options that are worthwhile considering beyond just the two biggies. So you can go and search for FulGaz in the App Store. It's super easy to find. It's the only thing spelled anything remotely like FulGaz. You can do either a two-week trial, or you can do a paid $10 a month sort of plan, or it's even cheaper if you do like an annual subscription and stuff like that. Click on Getting Started here, and this is where I can go ahead and pair up different sensors. So I've got it paired to my Wahoo KICKR CORE down here, and I can go down to Cadence and change it to something else if I want to, and then I can go into Heart Rate as well. So there we go, on down. And there's the ticker X that I'm wearing right now. And we'll click on Let's Go. In this case, the KICKR CORE is going to control the KICKR CLIMB. So that's going to control the gradient of the climb itself and therefore my bike. In the main home screen here, I can go ahead and view all different rides if I want to. I can go into some of their top picks. I can go to new rides, KICKR CLIMB approved rides. All rides are functional to KICKR CLIMB, but just some of them I guess I've done some more work on. Easy rides, group rides, hilly rides, long rides, group loop rides, mountain rides, and races. I've also got favorites down here and the rides I've already downloaded. So if I can, for example, go into the mountains rides, let me just go up there, oops, amidst, there we go. Into mountains, there's only three that are showing in this particular one, which is kind of strange. Like I think their filtering isn't quite working very well. So if I go up here and type in Alp for fun, you'll see there are a boatload of rides in the Alps. For example, Alpe d'Huez, different times, like this looks like it's a little more wintertime there. That one is definitely summertime. Tons of famous rides here to look from and choose from. La Tape du Tour, for example, and so on. So you can go and pick any of these rides if you want to. I can choose Alpe d'Huez right here. I can see who it was filmed by, so Monica Sattler. I can see the distance, a mere 8.89 miles. Of course, if you've done Alpe d'Huez, you know that's deceiving. And this person did it in 1 hour and 26 minutes, and the elevation gain there, 3,700 feet. You can, of course, change this to metric if you're of that persuasion. You can see the map, the incline, of course, the gradient right there. And if we go into settings, we'll be able to look at some cool stuff right here. So I've got ride history, of course, all my past rides, and then I've got ride mode. So this is how the video responds to the trainer. Are you going to go ahead and just have it simply match the video speed as you film that, or are you going to match your trainer speed? So we'll speed up the video if you are ahead of the film, or we'll slow down the film if you are behind it. Single play and laps. So some courses are really short. They're only like a couple miles long. So you can make laps out of them and just kind of seamlessly go over and over and over again. Kind of cool. Video quality, 4K, 1080p, 720p, SD. I've seen a little bit of an odd bug right now where when I choose to download a video in 4K, it keeps defaulting back to 1080p. I'm not sure what's going on there. I'm sure it's just a minor bug they just released this past week though. But they definitely talk about 4K videos being the big thing on Apple TV for them. Body weight, aerodynamic drag, rolling resistance, you can change all this kind of stuff if you want to make this feel more realistic. You can stream from a computer. This is a super cool geeky kind of option that allows you to go ahead and download the video files to a computer somewhere else on your network, even a NAS server if you want to, and go ahead and stream the video files from there instead of over the internet. Now keep in mind, Apple TV will download these files, but if you have like a smaller Apple TV with not a lot of storage, this is potentially an option for you if you want to download some big ass 4K files and a lot of them. Slope scaling, so this is kind of like trainer difficulty in Zwift. Slope limit, as far as how much it's going to replicate. Wheel size, KICKR CLIMB downhill limit. So if you went all the way down to the bottom, and let's say you had really long crank lengths or something, and you're about to hit the bottom there, this could solve that for you. In my case, I'm fine. Road feel for the Taxaneo, that's just sitting right there out of view. So allow you to replicate cobblestones and all that kind of cool stuff. Then we've got connectivity settings. So this is where I can go to upload to Strava. I can upload to Training Peaks, today's plan. I can shoot it to myself as an email. I can force an update of the list of the stuff and my subscription details and all that kind of cool stuff, kind of the usual that you'd expect in here. So in this case, I have not finished downloading this one right here. Instead, I'm gonna go ahead and download or look at these. You can ride them if you haven't finished downloading them, but I'm just gonna show you these because I've already got them downloaded. So I'm gonna start off here with Corkscrew Road. This is in Adelaide, Australia, kind of under the home of the tour down under there. Plop on this thing, and I'm gonna choose ride right here. I'm gonna start a new ride as opposed to saving a resumed ride. It's already telling me my kicker climb is in lock mode, so I'm gonna unlock it so it can take control. So kind of cool for them to notice that, like, Zwift doesn't do that. Just little nuances and stuff. And when you look at the nuances, that's what sort of makes this so appealing. For example, another climb thing they do is they go ahead and split the commands up. So typically the way climb works is that the app, like FulGaz or Zwift or whatever else, sends the trainer grade to the trainer, and the kicker goes ahead and sends that same grade to the climb. So if you were on a 5% grade, it would say, hey, send 5% to the trainer, mimics that down there, and then 5% up here. But Wahoo also supports sending two different commands, one to the trainer and one upstream then to the climb. And that's what they've done here, where they send the climb command 2 seconds faster than the kicker. And the reason they do that is it allows these two to actually match in terms of what your body feels. And it's really, really smooth. Like when you ride this, and if you go and ride Zwift side by side, this just feels better. It's as simple as that. Like it feels more realistic for whatever reason on the climb portion anyways. So on the left-hand side near this other rider's feet there, front wheel, is my speed. And I want to take a note of that. It says 14.1 miles per hour, 1.2, 1.26. That's how much faster I'm going than the original recorded video. So as a result, this might seem a little bit fast. And you especially notice it when he comes along next to me and you see his legs going very fast. And it probably feels like I'm going up this a little bit faster too because I'm going faster than it should be. Versus if I slow down here, there we go, get down to 1.0. The video is smoother, it's a little cleaner, and it matches a little bit better. And if he pops back into view here, you'll see his legs are where they are, what they should be. If I slow down, then it goes and it looks a little bit blocky as well, or a little bit kind of slow. There we go, we're almost exactly 0.93, so pretty close, so you don't really notice it. Let me just do this here. And you go beyond him, and probably see his legs. There we go. Now his legs look abnormally fast because of the fact that I'm going at 1.3 times original video speed. But you can turn that off in the settings if you want to, and just have it match whatever it was shot at, and you're kind of along for the ride there. So let's go ahead and look at another one real quick here for fun. We're gonna end the ride. I can save it for later, which is cool, because again, I can resume those rides. Just a neat idea to be able to like stop somewhere and resume it later. Don't know why other apps don't do that. And we'll go down here to the Columbia Ice Fields in Jasper. Here we go up in Jasper National Park in Canada. Start the ride. And this has got a different view. It's cool. They basically put the camera a little bit set back here, so you still have the handlebars in there, and even can see this person's Garmin there. So you know, not everyone will like this view, but it's kind of neat. Like, it's a different sort of angle on things, a little bit fun. I kind of like it for this particular ride. And you can see just how nice this scenery looks. It's just awesome. Super, super clear. Really nice stuff here. Now, I am recording this in 1080p from the screen. The recorder I have to record off of the Apple TV is maxed out 1080p, so I can't record it at 4K for you, unfortunately. So just keep that in mind. I need to spend some more money, apparently, and buy some more toys to get a 4K recorder. You can see here is the company of guys right now. I'm just a little bit under, so let me just change gears here to get the speed to match a little bit better there. So nice and smooth. There we go. Nice, the back two guys are riding with lights. So, front two guys, not so much. Daytime riding lights, always good. I've got my front one right here, though not the rear one on today, but I'm inside, it's all right. And here we go. And you can actually hear the cars, by the way. Let me see if I turn this up a bunch. You just barely hear them. Kind of a cool touch, though. And we're just climbing away. I mean, at this point, you're just cruising through the video. There we go. So, I just wanted to give you a little bit of a look at things. It's cool stuff. It does seem like they're limited to the same two device limitation that Zwift is on Apple TV. So you'll see right now, I never got my cadence off Bluetooth Smart. I did get heart rate, so I prioritized that from here. Unfortunately, with the Wahoo KICKR, it doesn't send cadence as well. So you can use other solutions out there, but I haven't tried those with the FulGaz app. FourEyes, for example, can funnel that data in, as can North Pole Engineering with their cable option. But again, I haven't tried both of those to see whether they work with FulGaz or not. So there you go, just a look at this, a really cool app. It's good to see some of the smaller developers being able to put out this kind of high quality stuff and compete against the big guys. And yeah, everyone has different things they prefer. Some prefer Zwift, some prefer Trainer Road, some prefer outdoor rides like this, or Ruvi, or Virtugo, or Rogan. There's tons of options. It's all about options. As consumers, you hope for options. You don't want monopolies in any area. Otherwise, those companies tend to stagnate and charge you more and do bad things. So all I'm saying is support the entire ecosystem at large, no matter who you support, because that's good for everybody. With that, if you found this interesting, whack that like button at the bottom there, or the subscribe button. I appreciate it. Have a good one.